truth, we got to start learning the difference between Jewish history and Hebrew Israelite history. You see that word Sepharvaim? That covers Sephardi, Sepharadic, and Sepharadim. Okay, in 722 BC, them people was placed in our land. They come from Babylon. The king of Assyria placed them in our land. They was Babylonian scribes. Okay, from 722 BC to 588 BC, it's like about 134 years. 134 years later, we abandoned our history to them. You see what I'm saying? They wasn't Hebrews. Let's go to the book and see. All right, 2 Kings. 2 Kings. All right, Israelite Brotherhood. Israelite Brotherhood. All right, 2 Kings, chapter 17. Chapter 17, verse 24. You see that word? You see that word, Sepharvaim, right there. Okay, we abandon our heritage to them in the book of Jeremiah. Like 134 years later, we Hebrews said we wasn't going to do the law no more. Then we was through with the covenant. And then we took off into Africa. You know, we took off into Africa to do the Egyptian religion. The Egyptians kind of like tricked us. So we stopped writing our history. You know what I'm saying? The book of Jeremiah, chapter 44, verse 15, 16, 17, and 18 show where the whole Hebrew nation, all the tribes, because we was made one on the way to Babylon. You know what I'm saying? The prophet Ezekiel held up 12 sticks. That's Ezekiel 37. You know what I'm saying? He held up 12 sticks, and the creator told him to bind them sticks and make them one stick. All right, he did that. And you can see that they was one when they come on from Babylon, because Israel was all in Judah's inheritance, and they wasn't talking about no tribes, which tribes you from. Okay, in 588 BC, we abandoned our heritage to the Babylonian scribes. We abandoned our heritage to the Babylonian scribes, and we quit writing history. You know what I'm saying? You got the exile history because they went to Babylon during the Babylonian captivity, and then they come back, and you got the book of Ezra, Nehemiah, Haggai, Zechariah, and Malachi. Those five prophets covered at 1%. Okay, when the Hebrews abandoned the covenant in the book of Jeremiah, the 99%, we stopped doing our history. You know what I'm saying? We stopped writing, and we didn't want nothing else to do with the covenant, and we abandoned our heritage to them Babylonian scribes. Okay, all the books outside the Tanakh is Jewish history. All the books outside the Tanakh is Jewish history. And those gonna be the people that we abandon our heritage to. You know, I got a couple of videos showing how they went all around the world making Jews out of everybody that they come in contact with. So it's gonna be a whole lot of confusion. But how you stay up out that confusion is that you understand Tanakh history. Once you understand Tanakh history, then you gonna know it's impossible for us to have wrote all them other books, which is Jewish history. See, Jewish history ends with the exiles. You know, the book of Malachi, that's gonna be our last book. That's our last book. The exiles were destroyed for mixing because we couldn't pass heritage off to them other people. We couldn't pass heritage off to them other people. You know, we couldn't do it. It was impossible to pass the heritage off to them other people. The creator wasn't having that, and they was destroyed. That's why the Greeks come in. But soon as they was destroyed and the Greeks set up shop in Egypt, then them Babylonian scribes, the Sepharvaim, moved to Egypt, and they start translating our history and then start writing additional books. So every single book outside the Tanakh history is going to be Jewish history. I don't care what kind of history they explaining or what they showing. It's going to be Jewish history. The Jews got to have a history too, because we abandon our heritage to them. That's why come the Jews say they are Hebrews today, is because we abandon our history to them. We abandon everything. We didn't take no covenant books into Egypt to do Egyptian religion. You know, the Egyptians wasn't having that. The Egyptians slick tricked us up out of our land, because we had to do, you know, the Egyptians had to do trade with the people in Mesopotamia. Look, you see Egypt right there? Look, you see Egypt right there? All right, boy, them folks had to do trade all over here, all in them other lands. So they tricked us out the covenant by putting us on that Egyptian religion. That golden calf represent a few religions that the Egyptians did, all combined into one. And we went into Africa to do that. Thus, being enslaved, just like the Creator said, we will be enslaved once we broke the covenant. Okay, we broke the covenant in the book of Jeremiah. And the 99% went into Africa. You know, here's the 99%. 2 Kings. 2 Kings 25. 2 Kings 25, verse 26. There it is, right there. And all the people, both small and great, and the captains of the armies arose and come to Egypt, for they was afraid of the Chaldeans. The Creator sent the Chaldeans, who slick Ashkenaz, you know what I'm saying? Because the Scythians made up the Chaldean army. And once we went into Africa, we abandoned our heritage to the Sephardis, who was placed in 722 BC, 2 Kings chapter 17, verse 24. And we abandoned our heritage to the Sephardis, to the Ashkenazis. You know, that's going to be... the Scythians that made up the Chaldean army. We abandoned our heritage to them for some Egyptian religion. And we stopped doing the covenant. We stopped doing the covenant at 100%. So it shouldn't be no Hebrews in Africa talking about that they the children of Israel trying to do a covenant up off the land. Those going to be the people that the Jews went inside Africa and did trade with. It's that simple. It's not hard no more. Hebrew Israelite history is easy. And it's real easy to the Israelite Brotherhood, because we got thousands of hours of research and study. You see what I'm saying? So when the Hebrew Israelite Brotherhood, when the Israelite Brotherhood show you something, we're going to be on point, because we ain't got time to play. We ain't got time to be debating the history. You know what I'm saying? We're going to lay it out. It is what it is. But like I say, us Hebrews abandon our heritage to the Jews, and the Jews are the people from 2 Kings chapter 17, verse 24. The word Sepharvaim covered the Sephardi Jews, the Sephardim, and the Sephardics. Those are one people, just mixed a little bit as they moved around. That's all. And Ashkenazi under the name Scythian, with the Chaldean army chased us out the land. You know what I'm saying? They was all from Babylon. And they made a lot of people into Jews. So when you start reading all these other books outside the Tanakh, you not reading Hebrew Israelite history. You're reading Jewish history. And a lot of people then got paid pushing Jewish history. That's like that book from Babylon to Timbuktu. Pure garbage. Pure garbage. Ain't no Hebrews went into Africa in 70 AD. You know what I'm saying? Those were the Edomite Sephardis that skipped across North Africa and went into Spain. Those were not Hebrews. Ain't no Hebrew prayed and worshiped at her temple, calling it his daddy house, as that Yawashi Jesus fella did. You know, it was a bunch of Jesus. Jesus being Anat, Jesus being Shaprat, Jesus being Gamal, Jesus being Thoth, Jesus being Stata. You know, it was a whole bunch of Jesus, and they all live during the same time, and they combine that history. See what I'm saying? That's like the Scythians settled in the Discopolis cities. The Discopolis cities, head city was Scythopolis. That's where the Scythians set up at. You see what I'm saying? That's where the Scythians set up at. Their history is all throughout the New Testament. It's a 500-year difference. It's a 500-year difference between Tanakh history and that New Testament history. That New Testament history gonna be the occupiers of our land. They occupied our land. Those are the occupiers. Us Hebrews went into Africa in the book of Jeremiah. We was on Egyptian religion. We had got tricked out the covenant. We had got tricked out the land. So ain't no Hebrews sit back and wrote all these books all over the world, everywhere, talking about the covenant that we broke. It was a done deal. It was a done thing. So us Hebrews abandoned the covenant. So whenever y'all run across some people that's trying to teach a history outside the Tanakh, they are teaching Jewish history. They are teaching Jewish history. They ain't teaching Hebrew Israelite history. So you're going to have to watch out for that mess. And how you put it in order is that you go back and refer to Tanakh history. Because Tanakh history is all we got. Tanakh history covers from the time that we broke the covenant to now, with no gaps in between. Moses set the curses out, and the curses is what it's been our whole life. So don't be getting tricked by all these books. You know, a lot of people done got rich off our heritage trying to sell books. Selling books and trying to pass them books over as Hebrew Israelite history because our heritage was blotted out. We don't know, and we're going to go for a whole lot of stuff. We're going to believe in a whole lot of stuff, and that's just the way it is. You know, we're going to believe in all this stuff because we searching and we want to know truth. But the truth is right before your eyes, the Tanakh. No matter what language it was translated in, the history going to be the same. So quit getting tricked out your heritage when you're trying to come into heritage. It's like they shutting the door on you before you even get a chance to walk in. You know, us Hebrews broke the covenant. Us Hebrews broke the covenant for Egyptian religion. We didn't sit around and write all these books. And then we didn't go into Africa with our tribal names. Our names was cut off because we had lots, land that belonged to us that we abandoned. So we abandoned everything. We just became one people. And those are the people that they took from the transatlantic slave trade from the Sahara. We didn't go to all these Europe, Asia, China, and all these places and set up and try to do a covenant. Those gonna be the Randonite Jews. I got a lot of videos on YouTube, Israelite Brotherhood on YouTube. Easy to learn the history now. We ain't got to be tricked no more. We ain't got to be tricked no more. And when people come talking about, this is Hebrew history, this is Israelite history, and it's outside the Tanakh, you being tricked. You being tricked. They sending you backwards. All we got is the Tanakh, which contains the Creator's word. When the Creator spoke to them prophets, that's what it is. That's what we got. And we got the curses for breaking the covenant. Plain and simple as that. That's why our heritage was blotted out. And we searching all them people like the Limbas, the Igaboos, and all them folks in Africa. All them people come off a Yemenite source. All them folks come off them people that ran into Africa in 70 AD. Them people wasn't shipped. Them people was pre-exposed to a Jesus and a Yahshua. That's like them Ethiopian Jews. Them folks come off them Hamite, however you pronounce the name. Them folks that come from Yemen. They are not the Hebrew Israelites. All Hebrews lost their heritage. Didn't no Hebrews escape the Creator's wrath. Them facts. And them facts you can see. Shalom, Hebrews. Quit getting tricked up out your heritage and quit believing them lies. And start understanding the difference between Jewish history and Hebrew Israelite history. Hebrew Israelite history gonna be the Tanakh. Jewish history gonna be all books outside the Tanakh. Plain and simple as that. It's that simple. Hebrew Israelite history is the Tanakh only. Hebrew Israelite history is the Tanakh only. Jewish history is all books outside the Tanakh. And then when they come with all these old secret books or special books, the Book of Enoch and all these books, Moses didn't push them books. Moses pushed the Torah. Moses brought us the Torah.
the Tanakh gonna be the prophet saying, you know, they like referees, you know, whenever we breaking the covenant, bow, they right there to point it out. So quit getting tricked up out your history by believing all these fantastic books. You know, they done sold a lot of books in these last days with us trying to wake up because we want to know our history. But your history is right before your eyes. Your history is the Tanakh. That's all we got. Some of you hate it. Some of you hate that all the history we got is the Tanakh, and you want our history to be all these fantastical books. But you can hang it up. You can hang it up. Them books gonna fall apart every time. Every time you start digging and start doing a little research, they gonna fall apart. This is the Israelite Brotherhood. We're a vanguard. You know, I'm the lead man right now doing the history. Shalom to the Hebrews. You know what time it is. You see what they say. Shalom.